very warm welcome to WS Cube Tech. So guys, in our previous session, we have covered categorical plots. In our today's session, we will be talking about the styling plots. So guys, styling plot is not a type of a plot, but styling plot means over here that we are going to style our plots. How we can style our plots, let's have a look on that. To style a plot, first of all, let's import all the libraries here. So I'll be writing import seaborn as SNS. I'll import matplotlib.pyplot as PLT. And lastly, I'll import pandas as PD. So once you are done with this, after this, I'll be loading the dataset. For that, I'll be writing ds is equals to load. And before that, we will be writing sns.load_dataset. And which dataset we will be talking about, let's take again tips.
Okay.
And in the tips, we will be getting all the columns. To get all the columns, in the first five rows, I'll be writing df.head. Open close the parentheses, and if I run it, I'll get the output in this way. So this is our output. Now what do I need to do? I need to create a count plot over here. To create a count plot, I'll be writing sns.countplot, where x would be equal to, let's say, the tip. All the tips are many, so with x is equals to day, and day should be kept inside the double quotations or single quotation. And our data is coming from our data frame. If I run it, I'll be getting count plot like this.
Okay,
so this is my count plot. Now, what if I want to do some styling? For styling, let's say I want to add some grids over here, or if I want to make the background dark or light. For that, what I'll be doing, I'll be writing over here sns.setStyle, and over here, I'll be writing, let's say, dark. So right now, the background over here is white, and if I put it to dark, you can now see that there is a dark shade over here at the background. This is because of our dark, and also let's just write plt.show over here. If I run it, this is how it looks like. This is dark. Similarly, you can get a white grid. So I'll be writing white grid. If I run it, I'll be getting a grid like this in the background. And you can see lines over here. These grid lines are very useful if you are working on a data. So suppose this is showing me over here, this is the line of 60 and it is somewhere around 61. Okay, and if I talk about this one, so this is just below 20, so it could be around 18 or something. Similarly, if I talk about this one, so it could be around 85, 86 something, and this one could be around 75 or something. So it is easy for me if I'm using grid lines over here. So there are two types of grid lines again. One is the white grid and another one is the dark grid. If I run it, I'll be getting a dark grid over here. So now you can see the grid is there, grid is still there, but now the lines, previously the lines were of dark color. Now these lines are of white color over here, and the background is dark. This is your dark grid. Similarly, you can see over here when we write, when there is Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday, and we have 0, 20, 40, 60, 80. We do not have lines over there, dashes. If you want to get those ticks over here, in that case, we will be writing ticks. And if I run it, I'll be getting some small ticks on these sides. So you could see previously if I write C and go back to dark grid, you will now see that those lines are not over here. But if I come back to ticks part, suppose if I write ticks over here and run it, then in that case you can see the ticks are available over here. So these are the styling that we can do in our background. Also, we can create a very beautiful color palette using it. So how to create a color palette? That means we will be creating a palette plot over here using different palettes. So let's have a look on how it can be done. So I'll be writing over here SNS dot. Because we are creating a palette plot, so I'll be writing pal plot. Pal plot over here means palette plot. And here I'll be writing sns.colorPalette. And if I run it, I'll be getting an error. This is because we have missed the parentheses. So if I run it, I'll be getting a color palette like this. So whichever color palette you want, you can pass that as well. Suppose if I get this again and I paste it over here, and if I write anything, let's say if I write any color map over here, for that I'll be writing, let's say, Viridis. And if I run it, so I'll be getting those colors which are there in Viridis. So we have Viridis, and suppose if I want three colors over here, so it will automatically decide the three color ranges over here and pass it to us. So if I write three, so it won't give me the starting three colors, but it will randomly give me any three colors over here. Not just randomly, but of equal distance over here. And if I want four of them, then these four I'll be getting. So I run it, this is how it looks like. And not just where it is, if you want to try any other color, suppose if you want to try spring, I'll be writing spring over here. And if I run it, I'll be getting all the colors that are there in the spring. Similarly, if you want deeper shades of this color over here, for that what you can do, you can write over here sns.palplot and sns.color_palette, and here you can write deep, and up to, let's say, I want 10 colors. So if I run it, is not defined because it is not inside a double quotations, and I'll be writing it inside like the double quotations, and if I run it, I'll be getting the deeper effect of the similar colors that we had on the top. You can see over here, similarly, if you want it to be bright, then in that case, I'll just copy this from here and paste it here. After this, we'll be writing bright, and we'll be getting a brighter version of the same colors that we had for the current palette. Similarly, if I paste it and if I write muted, and if I run it, this is how the muted looks like. Lastly, we have dark. For dark, all you need to do is write dark over here. And if I run it, I'll be getting the darker shades of this color. These colors, whatever our colors are, we are getting the darker shades over here. There are four things that we can try: deep, bright, muted, and dark. Similarly, lastly, if you want to create a color palette of your own, in that case, what you can do, you can define colors over here. So, suppose I want to create a colors list. Inside, you can pass any. So, let's go with the colors of the rainbow. So, I'll be writing with your. So, violet, indigo, blue, green, yellow, orange, and lastly, red. Close it over here. Once I have closed it here, I'll be writing SNS.palplot. Again, we will be creating a palette plot over here, and here I will be passing SNS.colorPalette, and inside this, I'll be writing colors. So lastly, once I'm done, I'll run it. You will see all the colors of the rainbow are here with us, our color palette. So red, orange, yellow, green, blue, indigo, and violet. So I hope, guys, that how styling can be done is clear to you, that how we have done styling. We can change the backgrounds over here. We can play with the color palettes as well. So the styling plot is not a plot itself, but it is giving the styles to our plot. So guys, I hope this session was clear to you. In our next session, we will be talking about the multiple plots. So stay connected, guys, and I'll see you in the next session. Thank you.